I've owned this tablet for less than a month and I've already installed a custom ROM on it. This is a Samsung Galaxy Tab A9 Plus, a tablet from 2023. I won it as a prize a few weeks ago. From the moment I turned it on, I knew that it could not remain on the firmware it shipped with. And here's why. At the moment, the tablet is running One UI 6.1. which is based off Android 14 with the February 2025 security patch. GSM Arena listed as shipping with One UI 5.1 based on Android 13, but I think my tablet in particular is a later revision because it came out of the box with Android 14. Using the build number and knowledge of Samsung binaries, we can deduct that this firmware was the fourth binary that was released for this tablet, and I will do everything in my power to keep the tablet on this U6 bootloader version for compatibility and recovery reasons. Now back to why I installed a custom ROM. This model of tablet is the weaker variant with 4GB of RAM and 64GB of storage. 4GB of RAM on a modern Android device is on the lower end of the spectrum. I'd argue barely enough to have a stable experience. There are many processes running on an Android device at any given time, and the less RAM you have, the less room you have for the things you actually want to do. There's a saying that unused RAM is wasted RAM, but it's not enough. And because One UI is one of the heaviest Android skins, you actually have even less room for the stuff you want to do, because of all the internal Samsung bloat that's eating up all the resources. So in order to save the most resources, I'm going to install a custom ROM. The ROM I'm installing is LineageOS, arguably the lightest custom ROM available for Android devices today. I went to the official website, checked the devices list, but the Tab A9 Plus wasn't listed as a supported device. And because installing ROMs built for other devices is a terrible idea, I had to use a GSI. GSI stands for Generic System Image, and it's pretty much a one-size-fits-all solution for custom ROMs on Android devices. Instead of custom building a ROM for one specific device, instead, a GSI could be built that works on more devices. GSI ROMs generally run on devices that ship with Android 9 Pie or higher that have an unlockable bootloader. In other words, any device that isn't from these countries, isn't made by these brands, and is factory unlocked. My Galaxy Tab A9 Plus meets all the criteria, so that means I can install GSIs. The one I'll be using is the latest LineageOS 21 pre-QPR2 GSI made by Andy Yan. The variant I'm using is the ARM64 BGN variant. ARM64 is because the tablet runs on a 64-bit ARM SoC. B stands for AB, and it's required for devices that ship with Android 10 or higher because they use system as root partitioning instead of system as system partitioning, in which case you need an A-only GSI. But A-only support was dropped a long time ago. G stands for Google Apps, which means the GSI comes bundled with the Google Play Store and all its dependencies. Right now, we're still on One UI. In developer options, we can see that it's currently using 2.1GB of RAM on idle, and I only have 1.4GB of RAM free, which is a massive no-no. That's not very good for an idling device. So I began the Lineage installation process. The first thing I had to do was unlock the bootloader. I went into developer options and enabled the OEM unlock option, which opens the tablet's bootloader for unlocking. Then I powered it off, held both volume buttons, then plugged the USB-C cable into the tablet with the other end plugged into my phone. Then the bootloader unlocking screen appeared. You're supposed to use a PC for these steps, but this was filmed at 2 o'clock in the morning and I didn't want to go over to the PC. I hit the volume up button to continue with the unlocking process. Then it factory reset for safety, so I had to set up the tablet again. I used my phone and the Eros flash tool, which works like Odin for mobile, to flash Orange Fox Recovery, a custom recovery used to flash custom ROMs and modification files. At the moment, the touchscreen doesn't work on custom recoveries on the Tab A9 Plus, but Orange Fox has a built-in failsafe where you can control the UI using the hardware keys, which are the volume buttons and the power button. Reminds me of Clockwork Mod Recovery from back in the day. We've truly come full circle. After this, I formatted the data and wiped the Dalvik cache. These are required steps before you flash a new ROM. Next, I rebooted to fast boot mode, because once you have a custom recovery like this, you're able to flash images with fast boot, even on Samsung devices which traditionally don't have working fast boot. With the Bug Jagger app on my phone, I was able to use fast boot to flash the LineageOS GSI to my tablet using this command. Then the phone started pushing the image to the tablet over fast boot, one sparse at a time. Finally, I installed Magisk via a recovery zip so I could get root access. Now it's time to attempt booting. If it doesn't boot, then I mess something up along the way. If it does boot, then I get to enjoy LineageOS. I reached the setup wizard and tried to proceed, but it kept crashing and returning to the beginning. This is a known issue which should be fixed soon, but for now you can skip the setup wizard by tapping the four corners of the device in a clockwise motion until it's skipped. I am now running LineageOS 21 on my Galaxy Tab A9 Plus, completely devoid of any Samsung bloat and junk, 100% clean. It's amazing to know that the tablet you're using is clean of OEM bloat that, over time, will grind it to a halt, use up all the resources, and make the experience painful to use. The next thing I did was install all my Magisk modules, which are packages that add functionality to rooted devices. Finally, I was finished. Everything runs wonderfully. It's so fluid and responsive. The tablet will be usable for a long time without the bloat of One UI hogging all the resources. Now I can watch content, play games, and study without knowing the tablet will spontaneously combust. If you made it this far, that means you enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you liked it, leave a dislike if you dislike it, comment your thoughts, and subscribe below to the channel. Thanks for watching.